Hi, my name is Kevin and I'll be your host for this tutorial. This is going to be a multi-part series on how to get Ionic, Cordova, Node.js, AngularJS all working on Windows 7, but the instructions will work with Windows 8 and Windows 8.1 with slight adaptations. By the end of this tutorial, we will have built a simple but fully functional Android application with surprisingly little effort. So who is this tutorial aimed at? This tutorial is aimed at people who know a little bit of HTML and CSS and may have dabbled in JavaScript, PHP or other scripting languages but now want to turn their skills towards Android app development. So you might be asking yourself, why wouldn't we develop an Android app natively? Well, this workflow offers us a number of advantages. The apps you create will work on iOS and Windows Phone as well as Android. Web apps are also very flexible and the UI design can be a lot more flexible in my opinion. This workflow also allows quicker prototyping since we can debug in the browser rather than having to run it on an emulated device or a phone itself. Now that probably all sounds like a lot, but please bear with me, it is quite simple. So let's get started. So the first thing we're going to do is open up a browser, any will do, but I'm using Firefox. I'm then going to go to Google and I'm going to search for Android SDK. After I've searched for Android SDK, I'm going to click the first result, which is developer.android.com. I'm going to scroll down the page and find Get the SDK for an existing IDE. Once I've clicked the download button, I'm going to agree to the EULA and read it all, of course. Then I'm going to click the blue download the standalone installer button and save it. Now that file is going to take a while to download, so I'm going to skip ahead, but once it's downloaded, we'll continue. The next step will be to install Java. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Google and I'm going to search for Java, Java SE Development Kit. Then I'm going to click the first result, which is number 7. It doesn't really matter if you get 6 or 7, but 6 is newer. I'm going to accept the license agreement, which you have read. And then I'm going to look for Windows x86 or Windows x64. Choose x86 if you have an old computer, x64 if you have a new computer. That should work. Then click Save the file and let it download. Again, this download's going to take a while, so I'll be back in a moment. The next step is to actually install Java. This will allow us to install the Android SDK. First off, click the download button, then select JDK 7U60, the file, click yes, and then it's basically just next, 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 next again, and then you may notice that it doesn't do anything for a second, but that's perfectly normal. Just give it a moment, and you can see it's now doing stuff. So after it's complete, I will come back and we will continue. The next step will be to actually install the Android SDK. This is what Ionic and Cordova use to actually build the packages and to actually emulate them. So what you'll do is you'll click on the download button again, select the installer underscore R23, or it might be R24 after this video, it all depends, I don't know if it's been updated or not. Then again, it's just next, next, but don't just keep clicking next, because there is a screen in a moment. Here it is. That destination folder, make a note of it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy it. So you can see I'm copying it. Then I'm going to open Notepad. And after I've opened Notepad, I will paste it in there and keep it for later. So I'm going to go back and continue clicking next. There's nothing else to worry about, so just click next and then install, and you can see now it's installing. Now this takes a moment again, so I'll be back with you when it finishes. The next step will be to install the tools that the SDK requires in order to create what we'll be creating later. Just follow these instructions basically. First off, make sure that Start SDK Manager is ticked. Once you've made sure it's ticked, click Finish. Now in a moment it'll bring up this window, it takes a few seconds to load, it's basically going away and checking what it can download. Now it'll have some stuff ticked by default, leave those ticked, those are important. Now you can see there it says Android L, that is Android 5.0. I personally won't be developing for that, so I'm going to untick it for the moment. You can leave it ticked if you like, but it'll increase your download time. Make sure 4.4 is ticked, and after you've ticked 4.4, click Install 9 Packages. Now in the bottom right hand corner you should see a button labeled Accept License. Click that and you'll see all the things tick. You've read all those license agreements, right? Then click Install and you can see it's now installing. This will take a while, so give it a bit, and when it's done I'll come back. The next step will be to add the path variable. Remember that note we made earlier? What we need to do now is open that as I am here. Excuse the mouse lag, not sure what's going on there. But once you've got the path variable open, you want to add a backslash and type platform-tools. Just like that. Once you've done that, I want you to copy the entire string, so everything there basically, just copy it. And then what you're going to need to do is click the Start button and right-click on My Computer and click on Properties. Now on the right-hand side there is an option called Advanced System Settings. Then click Environment Variables. Once you're there, find the Path variable, as I have there. Click Edit. Now get to the end of the string. Make sure you're at the end of it. Now add a semicolon and paste what you just copied. So you can see I've just pasted it. Then click OK, then click OK, then click OK again. Close everything out, and now the next step will be to log out of the system. So once everything's closed down, I'm going to log out. So now I'm logging out of the system, as you can see, and then I'm going to log straight back in. Now once I'm logged in, I'm going to click on the Start menu and search for Command Prompt. Basically we're just going to test to see that worked. So we're going to search for a Command Prompt. There it is, and I'm going to type A for Alpha, D for Delta, B for Beta, and you can see this text scrolling on the screen. If you get this, it means you've done everything correctly up until this point, basically. So A, D, B. That's all for now. Next step will be to install Node.js, which we'll move on to. So the next step will be to install Node.js. We're going to be using its package management facility in order to install Cordova and Ionic. Probably sounds complicated, but it's really not. Don't worry too much. So we're going to open the browser. Once we've opened the browser, we're going to search for Node.js. Then we're going to click the first result, which will be Node.js. Click the install button. Now I've already got it downloaded, so I'm not going to wait for it to download. I'm just going to run the installer, as you can see. Click Run, and then it is literally just next. Oh, here's that. Here's another long license agreement. You've read it and agreed to it, I hope. If not, expect to sell your firstborn to Richard Stallman, but hey, who knows. But anyway, so now it's going to install. This takes a while, so I'll be back with you when it's done. So now the install is done, we'll click Finish, and then close out, and we'll move on to the next step. The next step will be to actually install Cordova and Ionic. Everything we've done so far was just to make those work. This is actually why I'm doing this video. It's just because the documentation for these tools is subpar. We'll put it that way. Took me a while to figure out how to get it all set up. I might have just been being stupid though, who knows. Either way, so first off, we're going to open up the note, and I'm just going to show you what you're going to need to type in a moment. It's npm install g Cordova Ionic. Now, if you try typing npm at the moment, as I am here, you'll see it doesn't work. It'll just say, sorry, couldn't recognize it. Now, the reason that is because we haven't logged out or logged it. We haven't logged out and logged back in. So, we'll log off. And then we'll log straight back on, same as before. We'll open Command Prompt again, and then we'll type npm. And you'll see it works now. It actually shows some text. So we'll type that thing I said before. So it's N for Nova, P for Package, M for Manager, install, dash G, space, Cordova, C-O-R-D-O-V-A, and then space, Ionic. Hit Enter, and it'll start installing. Now this will take a while because it has to go and download stuff, so I'll be back with you when it's done. So now it's finished, we'll move on to the next step. So now that we've done all that, that basically concludes the first part of this tutorial. We have set everything up that is required. The next part will discuss actually getting a project up and running, and we will, by the end of the second part, have a basic HTML5 app that will work on Android, and you'll be able to test it yourself. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the second part.